Hello again. So now we're going to taste our section parcellaire from Le Domaine Bilao in the Roussillon. So the first one is VIT. It's made from Syrah, 60% Syrah, sorry, and 35% Grenache. Before we go in depth into the wine, could you maybe tell us the philosophy behind Sélection Parcellaire?
At first, definition of terroir, because when we speak of terroir, people are always thinking of soil, terre, soil. Terroir is not only the soil, terroir is one part soil, geology and pedology, one part climate, which is the microclimate and the vintage, and the third part is the human, the tradition and the talent of the people. And the terroir is, the academic definition of terroir is the conjunction of these six influences. And when we arrive on Sélection Parcellaire, the idea is to let speak the soil, but also the climate. In climate, there is vintage. That means we don't try to do the same wine for the consumer. We just try to do a pictures of the soil. That's been instead to try to make the best wine, we just try to make the best pictures. If there is a colder year, you will have more acidity, less alcohol. A warmer year, you will have more alcohol, less acidity. That's been the style will change, vintage after vintage, and we don't touch this and we don't correct it. The idea is the purity of the pictures. And when we identify a soil able to do that, normally we find a domain and then we try in the domain to find the best part to make a micro cuvée able to pretend to be a single vineyard. The first one we had is Eri.
No, this one is VIT, so this is from La Tour de France.
VIT.
And it's quite funny because this is 2017 and we would expect it from our Northern Rhone Valley eyes that it would be like quite of a Rhone vintage, but we can see it's quite fresh. So how could you explain there's an opposition in between vintages in Roussillon and in the Northern Rhone?
You have to keep in mind that we speak of a level of rainfall very low and there is no irrigation. The tradition in this region is that they don't plant the vineyard graft. They plant the rootstock. They let the roots go deep during 2 or 3 years, and then they graft on the feet. That means a big part of the roots are in the geological soil, not in the pedological soil. So that means a very poor soil. So that we have a low yield, but it's also because of this deep roots that we have and poor soil that we have, a wine rich in minerality and not rich in fruit. We feel it's a stone tea.
And what about the climate? Do you believe they were quite similar that year? Because you know, Rhone Valley was
no. I would say it is a little warmer, but the suffering of the heat is not so extravagant because we have a quite high density of plantation and we have deep roots. A big part of the secret is the deepness of the roots. So that we need to have a higher density of plantation and to push the roots. Keep in mind, roots can go to more than 100, 200, 300 feet down.
So like, why is it really important to have very old wine? And let's have a taste of very old wine. I from Lescada, they are about 80 years old vines, and they come from Lescada, so which I said before, it's about 500 meters high. It's a bit north from La Tour de France. That's our
and,
section.
And we are
as well.
On the granite.
And that's on granite.
What is interesting in the granite is that the granite has this, what we call petrichor signature. What I call a petrichor signature is the smell of rain, of summer rain on the hard stone. Imagine it is Sunday afternoon in August, it is 5 o'clock and the rain starts, this smell of the hot stone. And when you are on a granite and you have a low yield, then you have this nose. It's for that we find this characteristic of the granite. We are in the Syrah and we don't have the impression that the Syrah is coming from a warm place of France. We have the impression that we are coming from a quite cold climate.